Hey, I'm Gael Level, and this is OBS Studio. Today, I would like to talk about masking. It's a technique or feature used in motion design and graphic design software to partially or fully occlude a source using different levels of transparency. A practical way of demonstrating this is a mask. Let's say I put this mask on my face.
So now you can no longer see my face,
but instead you're seeing the mask. Now imagine if the mask was invisible and we just wanted the effect of occluding my face without showing the mask itself. Then we would have this effect. Now, using this basic principle, we can do some pretty creative stuff in OBS Studio, so let's get started. Now, OBS actually comes with a system for you to apply some masks. If you go to any source, you go to filters, you click plus to add a new filter, you will see something called image mask slash blend. You can add that, and it will ask you to basically browse for a file. And if I use any image editing software, such as MS Paint, I could create a black and white image where white will reveal, black will hide, and of course, different shades of gray will control transparency. I'm gonna save this, then I'm gonna click browse and find it. It's right there. So now when I click open, it will be applied to my camera. Now to demonstrate the transparency, we can add some gray, some more white. Save the image and you can see the effect. So that's with vanilla OBS. You can do this right now. Obviously, the problem there is that we depend on another software. We need to create those images if we want to update. It's not on the fly. Well, there's a way to create those shapes and then use them as masks. And it's called Advanced Mask by Finite Singularity. This is an OBS plugin. You usually download it here. You just install it. Click next, 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 and install. And when you reopen OBS Studio, you can add a filter, Advanced Mask. Now, of course, you can add that directly to your source. We can have our ellipse, polygon, star, heart, which is all nice. We have a bunch of control over all of this, rotation and everything, but we can also use another source as the mask. So you see under mask type, you'll find source, but right now we don't have any other source. So I'm gonna upload an image. For example, I'm gonna add an image and let's find something random with transparency. Oh, May from Overwatch. Perfect. Let's go back to the filters for the camera. And in my advanced mask 2 here, so the source will be my image 2. And as you can see, now it... now my webcam shape is made from Overwatch. Now here's the thing. It's stretching to fit. We can go ahead and put that to manual. And then we can place it correctly where we want. So first of all, I'm going to scale it up. Nice. And I'm going to play with the position. X, and there it is. So with just this plugin, you can create shapes on the fly, modify them on the fly, but also use other things as masks, not just a black and white image that you have to update all the time. But on top of all that, you have the ability to stack those filters. I can right click duplicate on my filter. Boom. So now I have two filters that are creating this mask, right? On the second one, I'm going to go down and I'm going to click invert mask. So instead of revealing my camera where the maze shape is, it's going to remove it where the maze shape is. So it's going to create this tiny outline. So the second mask is trying to show me everything but that shape. And the top mask is showing me just that shape, creating this outline. It's kind of a quick way to create some sort of border, I would say. Now I can play with the scale and the position to have it how I want. Now the question is, could you use this with something that is animated? Can we have animated masks? I'm gonna go ahead and find something animated. For example, this GIF. I'm gonna make sure I set everything back to default for this mask. I'm gonna go mask type source, of course, and then source we want image 2. And there you have it. Of course, it is stretched now. Once again, we can set it to manual. Place it appropriately, just like that. And if that's like, if I wanted this to be kind of like my webcam border or something, this is it. You done it. Now, of course, I'm just showing you with the webcam because it's the most obvious, but you can add this to any, absolutely any source. Okay, now you want some practical example other than just my webcam shape, right? I made a video about creating a shockwave effect. The whole thing with the shockwave is that you need a ring shape. And within that ring, you need some distortion. And then you just need the ring to expand. That's it. Now, of course, if we want a shockwave to appear, we don't want our webcam to be completely masked. We want the webcam to stay the way it is and then just have that ring of distortion on top of it. So what I need right now is to have a duplicate of my camera. There are multiple ways to do it. I could put this in a group and then duplicate the group, add some filters to that group, or use a plugin called Source Clone that allows you to basically add a new source that's going to clone another source. So when you install this one, in your sources, you will find something called Source Clone. I'm gonna call it ring, clone type source, and the clone is going to be whatever you want. But in this case, we're gonna go with cam. Nice, nothing changed because it's the same source. technically. It's just a clone. Now, if I add some filters to that specific clone, filter, color correction, just for an example, saturation, ooh, look at that, boom. And then my original cam is not affected. All right, the clone, not the clone, the clone, not the clone. Okay, let me remove this. There's one single thing that I don't necessarily like about the advanced mask plugin, and maybe I'm wrong, maybe there's something that I'm missing, is that when you create a shape, for example, like a circle, I don't have that invert mask capability. What if I wanted to create a circular hole in my scene? So that's something that would be so, so useful, which forces me to actually create a different circle to use as a base shape. And what I do is I usually go to a color source, add that, and then I'll add my circle advanced mask to it. So go boom, advanced mask, boom, boom, shape, of course, circle. And just for the sake of it, I'm going to make that circle pretty big like this. There you go. And I can actually turn it off. Color source 3 is the name. We need to remember that. I'm going to drag it down just to make sure that I don't mess with it. Now with my source clone, the ring, I'm going to go ahead and go to source for my mask type. And the source will be color source 3. I'm going to go to scaling. We're going to need to scale it down later on. And I'm going to set that to manual. And there's actually an option that I didn't pay attention last time. And I feel silly because I just discovered it. Well, discovered. I just figured it out right now. And it would have helped in my previous tutorials. But there is a positional alignment option here. So going center for that positional alignment is going to help us a whole lot. We're just going to make sure to move it around. Just like that. And now we can duplicate this mask and we're going to create that hole, right? Duplicate. I'm going to scroll all the way down on that second one. I'm going to click invert mask, go all the way back up and start scaling it down. And that's why the positional alignment is so important. All right. I think that's enough. And this will give us an idea of that ring and where our distortion is going to affect. Now let's add that distortion that I talked about. For that, we're going to use OBS Shaderfilter by Exaldro, another plugin that gives you a bunch of effects, including ripple, as you can see here. So let's go ahead on that ring. We're going to go user-defined shader. That's the shader filter. We're going to go load shader text from file, click browse, and you should find like hundreds of examples. We're going to click on ripple, click open, and it should ripple. But now the problem is that our whole donut is rippling, which is something you can probably pick. Like you can see the effect now. Oh, this is weird. In order to have it be contained inside of the donut, the rippling effect, that is, you can bring that ripple effect all the way up in your list because that order matters. So once up and twice up, now the rippling is only inside. There we go. I'm going to make it more dramatic just so that it's very, very visible. I have like a very plain background, so you don't see a lot of distortion. You don't see enough distortion. There you go. And you can also set like the power. More ripple. Oh my God. Now there's literally so many ways that you could actually animate that ring to create a shockwave effect. But most importantly, we're going to use the move plugin. Wait, editor guide level here. I kind of went off the rails with this tutorial. I spent way too much time explaining in depth how the move plugin works when this is not a video about the move plugin. If you want to know how to make a shockwave effect, watch my shockwave tutorial. It shows you everything. It actually shows you a better technique than here. All you need to know is that I use the move value filter in order to move the inner ring and also the outer ring. That's it. It created like the donut, the ripple, and it goes away and boom, you have a shockwave. That's it. Anyways, that's one quick and dirty way of doing it. One of the things that people ask me a lot also is how do I have this glossy background for my chat? I started off with a color source, just like that. And I added an advanced mask filter. And then I created the exact shape that I wanted. That's the beauty of the advanced mask filter is that if I wanted like a rounded rectangle, like that, I can just place it. I know that my chat's gonna be around here, just like that, bump up the height, fine tune it, okay? And I can actually turn it off. And now using that source clone that I showed you, you can add a source clone, pick the source that you want to clone. In my case, it's called cam, right? No difference. We're gonna add an advanced mask filter to that, boom. And then under mask type, now we want a source. Which source do we want? That color source, right? Color source 3. Right there, you can see it takes the shape of the chat. So far, so good, even though we don't see any difference. Now we can add any effect that we want. Let's say we wanted color correction, for example. I wanted this part to be super saturated. I can do this. Not saturated, I can do this. You can make it brighter or darker. And of course, if you want to make it blurry, Then you can use some blurs and the shader filter plugin, although they might be a little CPU intensive. What I recommend you is to use the Composite Blur plugin for OBS Studio. It's pretty optimized to not use too much resources, although like don't go too wild with it. So let's do just that. It will be added as a filter. I can go Composite Blur right there. Click OK. And just like that, I have my blur. Now, you can see that it's blurring, like I'm getting an outline, and that's because my blur is under my mask, right? So it's like mask and then blur everything from bottom to top. So all I need is to get the blur on top, and boom, it is now contained. And if I do this, now we have our blur level. Now, the extra magic with this is technically I could still go back to my color source without even turning it on. I can go to the filters on there and move my blur around just like that. So if I wanted my chat to be on the left side for some reason, all of a sudden I can do this. I can do this. If I want to follow my chat or pretend that I'm moving it with my hand. And of course, it also means that you can create all sorts of easy graphic design projects. Since you now have the ability to create a bunch of shapes from a basic color source like that, I could do this, maybe add some text, select my font, place that here, add an image like the Twitch logo, place that here, group it all up, holding shift, right click, group selected items, move it to where it would. Hold on, I think I have my clone source in there. Let's remove that. All right, move this to where you would want it. For example, here, of course, this is huge. And using the move plugin, I can go to the scene filters, add a move source, call that tag on screen. Under source, I can select tag, custom duration, 1000 milliseconds, get transform, duplicate this, call this one tag off screen, click OK, grab my tag, bring it down, click get transform. And now if I'm using something like StreamerBot or any other bot that can control my OBS sources and filters, I can just do this from time to time. And I have a social media pop-up. It could be your Instagram, your Twitter, your whatever. If you are using StreamerBot, it can also be a shout out command. And since StreamerBot can get you info on the user, you can even display their profile picture. All of that straight with StreamerBot and OBS. No outside software. And that was the basic rounded rectangle. If you want more complicated shapes, of course, you can just combine a bunch of color sources with that advanced mask filter. All right, let me loop this for no reason whatsoever. All this to say, if you have a couple of OBS plugins and you know how to use them, or just like even basic OBS filters, you can create some pretty awesome stuff. And yes, if you're using something like Adobe After Effects, if you're an actual pro motion designer, those might be better to do motion graphics. But inside of OBS Studio, you have access to all of the data, meaning that through StreamerBot, for example, if I wanted to let my chat use channel points or bits, or even use my heart rate to change the color of the background of that little pop-up, I can do that pretty easily, actually. If I wanted the text to change, I can do that. You can't do that with something that you baked in a motion design software. Hopefully I made my point across. This is actually my actual Twitch handle, so follow me there and I'll see you later.